لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الميامين وسلم تسليما. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, a lot of Muslims recite Quran nowadays, and they do not understand the basic meanings of Quran. For example, the word Iman, the word أقم الصلاة, إقامة الصلاة, what does it mean? The word, those words, they are linguistically easy to understand. But we have to follow the meaning according to Quran and Sunnah, not only the linguistic meaning. Every word of those has a specific meaning. The word Iman, الذين آمنوا, المؤمنين, المؤمنون, يؤمنون, تؤمنون, this word has a meaning in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, the great angel, in the form of a man who sat in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the masjid and asked him about Iman, a question meant to teach the companions and to teach the Muslims what is Iman. Therefore, it is important to know it according to what Jibreel taught the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and according to the answer of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Everyone, whether Muslim or not, thinks that he has Iman one way or another. The Christian thinks so, the Jew thinks so, even other pagan religions, the pagan religions, they think they have faith, they have Iman. But none of those faiths or Imans count. Only the true Iman, only the true faith, the faith that is based on the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which we have in the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the faith that counts, at the top of which is Tawheed, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His Lordship, in His perfection and attributes, and in His worship. And then the rest of the articles of faith, one has to understand them in the right way. Otherwise, without faith, your actions will not be worth anything. Actions follow faith in the Book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, we have to understand the right meaning of the faith. A lot of so-called, unfortunately I have to say, so-called Muslims nowadays act against Tawheed in different ways, and they think they are faithful. They supplicate to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They sacrifice animals for other than Allah. They give oaths of gold and money and things like that to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like the idol worshippers were doing with their idols. No difference. But the Muslims nowadays call their actions by different names, thinking that that will justify what they are doing. You cannot commit shirk and call it love and think that this will save you from the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or commit shirk and call it tawassul or whatever other name. You cannot do that. You cannot exaggerate in the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and raise him to the level of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and call that call it something else, call it complimenting the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or loving the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Therefore, the Muslim has to be careful about those basic things. Unfortunately, thousands nowadays call themselves Muslims and commit great shirk in different ways. Thousands of Muslims don't have the right faith in the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have been affected by sources other than the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nowadays, if those Muslims see, for example, certain programs on TV or whatever, that angels are represented by little girls or women or whatever, they might not object to it, thinking that this is okay or nothing is wrong with that, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated clearly in his book that only those who are Kafirs think of angels as daughters of God. That's because the Arab pagans who were worshipping the idols were making such idols either as representatives of angels whom they believed to be daughters of God, or representatives of pious people. So that's why they were worshipping those idols and taking them as steps and means between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Instead of asking Allah directly, they would go through them. Therefore, my dear brothers, one has to be very careful. At the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, some people recited Quran, but they did not understand it the right way. For example, the verse in which defines the time of Fajr, until the white robe is distinguished from the black robe. A man at that time, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He said, okay, this is simple. So he took two ropes, one white, one black, and he put it next to his head. So when he, before Fajr, he was looking to see, can he distinguish or not? Thinking that this is the meaning of the verse. And this happened at that time. So it could happen now, and it is happening now. People read, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ how many times? At least 17 times a day. At least. And when something happens to them, instead of calling Allah, they call names. Names. And they shout in the name of such, and the name of such, and the name of such. They ask other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what is the meaning of إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ? You see. Because they don't understand the meaning of ibadah. They don't understand the meaning of ibadah. There is only some kind of meaning in their minds which is not the true meaning of ibadah. That's why they worship other than Allah and they don't think they are worshipping other than Allah. They don't understand that. This also happened in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when a Christian priest, Arab Christian priest, came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanting to become a Muslim. And Adi, this man was Adi ibn Hatim, radiallahu anhu. So Adi heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting the verse, اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله. And he was wondering, how could this be? I am a priest. We did not take our rabbis and monks as lords besides Allah. Why? Because he did not understand the right meaning of worshipping or considering someone as a lord or as a god. He thought that is only when you prostrate to him or things like that. He limited the meaning in a way that makes him don't understand. So he said to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Messenger of Allah, we were not worshipping them. Okay. That's good. The Muslim should ask, especially when it comes to the basic things in Islam, the most basic thing, and that is tawheed and worshipping Allah. You ask. So he asked the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained it to him. He told him, look Adi, didn't you follow your scholars when they made what is unlawful made it lawful, and when they made what is lawful to be unlawful, they accepted the legislation of their scholars and gave it priority to the legislation of Allah. He said, yes, we did, we used to do that. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that is worshipping them. You have been worshipping them by this. This is worship, you see. To obey someone and give priority to his order over the order of Allah This is worshipping him besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yet, we find, unfortunately, a lot of so-called Muslims give priority to not only their scholars' legislation, but their rulers' legislation, their sheikh's legislation. Sometimes the sheikh tells them, no, Allah says, don't do this, and the sheikh says, oh, it's okay, go ahead, do it. Okay. And they don't stop and say, this is against the legislation of Allah. How can we do it? The shaitan whispers to them, he's a sheikh. He knows better than you. So he's telling you, go ahead and do it, it's okay. He must know something you don't know, so you go and do it. But you know it is haram. You know that Allah said it is unlawful. Therefore, the Muslim has to seek the knowledge of the basic things in Islam. Seek the knowledge so that he does not fall into things which contradict the true faith. Our faith in the divine decree. This is one of the pillars of faith. A lot of Muslims nowadays have misconceptions, at least. And some of them are altogether deviant in regard to having faith in the predestination. Therefore, and the rest of the articles of faith, don't think that if you just say, I have faith in the messengers, that's enough for you to achieve, to be really faithful in the messengers. You have to know how to have faith in the messengers of Allah, how to have faith in the angels of Allah. There are verses in Quran about the angels. Why? Why are those verses in Quran about angels? We should use them. We should understand them in the right way. There are verses in Quran about messengers, about the books of Allah, and about the divine decree. We have to understand them. There are hadiths of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam shedding more light on those articles of faith and giving examples and to make the subject more clear. Therefore, we have to seek this knowledge. Knowledge does not come to you in dreams or here and there. No, knowledge, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلْمِ. Knowledge comes by seeking. You go and seek it. If you find someone trustworthy who teaches this knowledge, you go and sit and listen. And if something is vague, you ask and you make sure. Otherwise, there are books, alhamdulillah, a lot of books that have been written, but you have to go and seek it. Don't say those are fundamentals and I should know them easily and this. No. This is the way of the devil to make you not study them, not learn them. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah recited one surah, wal asri innal insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihat wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr. He said, If this was the only surah in Quran, or no other surah was revealed, this would have been enough. You see, this would have been enough. But what does this mean? It means it would have been enough if understood in the right meaning. Otherwise, as we mentioned, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, a lot of people think that they have iman and they have faith. And actually, they have a lot of things against the true faith, and they don't know them. So the point is, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, says, answering the question of a man who wants to know how to go to paradise, the Prophet tells him, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ. Say, I have faith in Allah, and then be straightforward on acting upon what Allah has ordered you. So, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ one has to understand how to achieve it. It's not just saying it by tongue. This is not the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just to say things by tongue without understanding the right meaning. This is not the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the whole point again is that the seeking the knowledge of Sharia is an obligation. Especially seeking the knowledge of your faith and your obligations, Salat and Siyam and so on, how to perform the right Salat, and how to perform the other pillars of Islam. You need to study and ask and learn so that you can do them according to what Allah said. If you just pray like the people do without knowing the right Salat, you might not be doing the basic requirements of a Salat. In every madhab, they teach you the pillars of the Salat and the conditions of the Salat. The conditions are those things like wudu, like time, like facing the Qibla and so on. Without them, your Salat is not accepted altogether. And the pillars are of similar value, but they are in the Salat itself. Like Takbiratul Ihram, like Rukur, like Sujood and so on. Like the Salat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Salat. These are the pillars of Salat. And there are other pillars. Let's take for example one pillar, and that is the settlement and what is called in Arabic At-Tuma'nina. Tuma'nina is not khushu'. Khushu' is in the heart. Your heart has to be attending and not away. This is khushu'. But Tuma'nina is to have the right settlement in Salat, and Ruku' and Sujood, and all Salat. To pray with calmness and settlement. And to be in each pillar of Salat for a certain time. This is called Tuma'nina. Again, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a man came to the masjid and he said, "Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah," the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he prayed two rak'ahs before joining the group. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him and he told him, "Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. Go back and pray because you have not prayed." And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him making some moves and what he thinks to be prayer. But since they missed the tumanina, the settlement, he was making them quickly and not settling in his salah. And he thought he made the salat, and he came to the Prophet again and he said, "Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Wa alaykum as-salam. Go back and pray because you have not prayed." Until he did it for the third time, then he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, "O Prophet of Allah, O Messenger of Allah, I really don't know better than this." See, this is how the Muslim should be. Don't be shy of learning your religion. There is no use of this kind of shyness. This is not the shyness that the Muslim should have. You should be shy of doing sins. You should be shy of being reluctant to obey Allah and His Messenger. But not be shy to learn your religion, and especially the basics. In salat, if your salat does not fulfill the requirements, the minimum requirements, it's not accepted. And if it's not accepted, then none of your other actions will be accepted. Even your behavior with people, you are rewarded for it. But without the right salat, you have no reward for this. Your obedience to your parents, this is a great reward. But without the right salat, you will not get any reward on the hereafter. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the first thing that will be looked into of your actions on the day of judgment is your salat. If it is good, then everything else will follow as well. And if it's not, then none of your other actions will be looked into. You see. And despite that, we find a lot of people pray carelessly anyway. They pray carelessly anyway. You find someone who comes to the masjid and he missed, for example, one rak'ah, he joins the congregation. Even though the congregation is praying right, he is not praying right. Okay. He could just follow the congregation, but no. He is not praying right. He is praying quickly. He is racing the imam. I don't know what does he want to do, yani. He is racing the imam and he is making sujood before the imam, he is making ruku' before the imam, and he is making salam before the imam. Subhanallah. So the Muslim has to be very careful. So when it comes to faith, you have to learn it, because with the wrong faith, nothing will be accepted from you, not even your salah. When it comes to salat, you have to know the right salat, how to do it in the right way. What are the pillars at least? What are the conditions? These are the minimum requirements, the pillars and conditions. You have to learn them. In every madam, they list them. Some of them say the pillars are 9 of them say the pillars are such and such, and they list them. And they explain about each pillar, how to achieve it. This is basic knowledge that the Muslim needs. We need to learn engineering and technology and this to improve our strength in this life. But we need to learn the basics of our religion in order for us to have a good hereafter, to be in paradise, and to be saved from hellfire. Otherwise, hellfire will be so big, and there is a place, there is a place there for, those who don't pray and so on. So we have to be careful, and we cannot just keep on ignoring the basic things and ignoring before. We have to be careful because you don't know about this life. You step outside and something happens to you and you're gone. So you have to be careful. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who listen and follow the best. And this kind of knowledge is an obligation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered it in his book, saying, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. Know your faith in Allah. Know it. Know your tawheed. Seek knowledge of it. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمْ. Seeking or earning the knowledge is by seeking it, not by wishing it. By wishing it, you don't get it. If it was by wishing, then why don't you sit in your home and wish that your salary will come to you without working? Can you do that? No, because that's for this life. So I have to go and strive. I have to go and do things. I have to go through college, and I have to go through a lot of studying so that I get the degree and do this and do that. So how about the hereafter? It also starts with knowledge. It also starts with knowledge. Without knowledge, the Muslim will be subject to the misconceptions, and he will be an easy prey in the times of fitna. He will be an easy catch for those who want to spread their evil ideas. He will be easy to fall into their traps if he does not know his faith, and if he does not know his religion the right ways. And in our times nowadays, we are passing through so much of those ideas of atheism and kufr and everything, and innovations, and we are going through all kinds of afflictions. So, without having the right knowledge, we are targets. We become targets. And no one should say, no, I am safe. No. And it is our duty to encourage our children and to encourage our dependents, to encourage them to study their religion Some people emphasize on making their children memorize Quran, and this is beautiful, this is good. But better than this is to make them learn Quran, learn the meaning, so that they can apply Islam and to go by Islam in the right way, and so that they will not be easy targets for the traps of those who call to their misguidance. Especially the youth, and especially the children, are easy targets also. There are a lot of programs which include wrong ideas regarding faith that are spread. And if we don't learn our religion and we don't make our children protected by making them learn the faith and learn their religion, we will be responsible for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا Save yourselves and your family and your children. This is an obligation also. To save yourself and your family and your children. To make sure, when we find that parents taking good care of their children regarding their livelihood, regarding their studies and things like that, we say, mashallah, these are good parents. But how about taking care of what saves them in the real life, in the hereafter? This is more necessary. This is more necessary as a Muslim. This is given a priority. And this is more necessary, to save your children from hellfire. And this comes by teaching them first the right religion. And not only making them memorize the Quran or memorize the Hadith. Alhamdulillah, this is good, but this is not enough. As Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhuma said, لا إعراب القرآن أحب إلينا من إقامة بعض حروفه. To understand Quran, to understand Quran. And as one of the companions said, we were not letting ourselves pass by 10 verses before learning the meaning of those verses and acting upon. Learning the meaning of those 10 verses and acting upon them. So this is our way as Muslims. And this is the difference between us nowadays and between the people before us who were leaders of the world and who were spreading Islam everywhere. By their actions, by their morals, by their understanding of Islam, the true understanding, the true faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the true faith in the angels and the messengers and so on. This is a reminder for myself first and for you all about seeking the knowledge of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and making sure that we do it in the right way and I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who listen and follow the best. Allahumma aghfir lana warhamna wa tub alayna wa afina wa aslih lana amrana kullih. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم وانصر إخواننا المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم وانصر مسلم الشام اللهم انصرهم على عدوهم وعدوك اللهم يا جبار السماوات والأرضين عذب الكفر المعتدين الله. Allah will give him success to do good actions, to fix his outward, the actions. Inward is not only the intention. The intention is important, but besides ikhlas, sincerity, there are other actions of the heart that the Muslim should take care of. For example, there is yaqeen. Yaqeen is very important. Yaqeen means surety of the heart. No doubts about what Allah says and about what the Messenger says. No doubts about the religion of Allah. And you know how we achieve surety. We have to seek the right knowledge. So surety is one of the actions of the heart, one of the inward things that is very important that we need to improve. And we also have the love. One of the actions of the heart, to love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to love the religion of Allah, and to love the angels, and to love the pious people. This kind of love is a very important action of the heart. This is one of the important things in our inward actions. We also have the sidq, the truthfulness of the heart. The truthfulness of the heart is a condition of faith. You have to be truthful. You cannot contradict yourself. You cannot say, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah," and then when something happens to you, you immediately turn to other than Allah and call the name of other than Allah. You see, this means there is no truthfulness in your heart. There is no This is hypocrisy. This is not truthfulness. To contradict what you say just like that, you have to be truthful. And we have to teach ourselves to learn to be truthful in our hearts. Everything is by learning it and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. So we want to be truthful in our hearts. Also, we also ask Allah to help us in that. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. So fix your inward as much as you can. Don't ignore your inward. Fix it. Fix your sincerity. Fix your truthfulness. Fix your yaqeen. Improve it. You see, this is a very important thing, that you try, strive hard. As the companion said, تَعَلَّمْنَا الْإِيمَانِ. We learn the faith. So these are things which are part of the faith in your heart, that you have to learn, and you have to build on, and you have to improve, you see. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst the real faithful, and to make us amongst those who strive hard and in learning the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Allahumma wansur ikhwanana al-Muslimin fi kulli makan. Wa farrij an al-mustad'afina والمشردين. اللهم فرج عنهم. اللهم اجعل لهم أحسن مخرج وأجره. اللهم وانتقم من الظلمة الفجرة ومن الكفرة. اللهم انتقم منهم وأرنا فيهم عجائب قدرتك يا أرحم الراحمين.